Hey everyone, this is Ken, and today we're going to be doing a tutorial on a digital clock, which is great. Now check it out. Before I even get into all the details, let me just show you how this works. You're going to go right over here in this section right there, and you're going to press that button. Now the second you press that button, you're going to notice immediately that the clock is going to be working. And the cool thing about this is you can really set this up to two different styles. You either have Minecraft time, or you can make this like a real clock and have real time, which is awesome. Now, another cool feature added to this was this AM and PM setting. Now, I'm going to fast forward this to about 12 o'clock, and you're going to notice the second it hits 12, the AM is going to switch to PM. See that? That's perfect. Now the cool thing is, every time it hits 12 o'clock, it will always switch over, just like so. Now the rest of behind this entire design is quite simple, especially for what it's worth. I mean, compared to a lot of other designs, the problem I noticed was the fact that people use a lot of repeaters, which is also create a lot of lag in the system. Now, in this design, we use very minimal repeaters to really avoid that, and we try to simplify the redstone dust as much as possible. And just from looking at it, you're going to notice how simple the design is really is. Look at that, it's amazing. Now you're probably wondering what that obsidian is for. That's more of a security feature, but trust me guys, I will definitely explain that later on in the video. And as you can see guys, it has a very compact, simplistic style to it. So check it out, this is the basic material we're going to use. We'll be needing a block of your choice, some half slabs, hoppers, droppers, glass blocks, redstone dust, redstone torch, repeaters, comparators. We will be needing some redstone blocks, redstone lamp, and the reason I'm saying obsidian or furnace, for the simple fact you need a block that's unmovable, but that's completely optional, but I'll explain why later on. And you will also need pistons and sticky pistons. Fantastic. So, check it out. At this point, guys, try to have an area of this amount of space, okay? Try to set this up and pause the video at this point, especially before we even start the build. Now, once you've done that, I want you to go to one corner and go about one block in right there. Now from this point, you're going to go all the way to the right, or to the left in this case, and bring it up exactly 11 blocks straight up. Perfect. Yes, I said it. Now one more time, we're going to go about 11 blocks upwards. And on the 11th block, you're really just going to connect it from one end to the other. Now, right over here, we're going to place a block there, a button right in front of it. I'm going to delete, put a block there, and a button as well. And I personally like to put a redstone lamp right on the side of it. Now, from this point, we're going to place a block over here and pretty much create another frame one block wider on each side. See? Now at this point, you're going to place two blocks going forward and then once again wrap it all around and create the same exact frame. Now right over here, delete that. Once again, bring it up one more time. And what you want is to create this really nice framework. Now of course, you want to decorate the front just a little bit. Just give it that nice look to it. Now guys, this is really completely optional. You can really make it your style. Now right over here, you're going to place a block there, you're going to delete that, place a repeater going forward, and two pieces of redstone dust. Then you can place a repeater right there, one block going forward. Then you're going to place three blocks right in front, see? And one more right there. You're going to place one dropper right there going inwards, one going upwards, and one going the opposite direction on top with a hopper going straight down. and a comparator going forward. Now what we're creating here is a silent T flip-flop. I'm going to place a block in front, delete that, a block on the side, a block right there, and a repeater on the inside going forward. And you're going to delete that block. Then you're going to place one piece of redstone dust on top of that block. Fantastic. Now make sure you put one piece of dirt in that dropper. See? Right there. Then you're going to delete that block. And you're going to place a redstone dust on top of that block and inside as well. Fantastic. Now at this point, I want you to go to the side over here and you're going to delete all three blocks going forward. Place a repeater there and two pieces of redstone dust behind it. Then you're going to place a block on top of that to cut that off. And you're going to delete that, place a repeater going forward inside as well, one more time. Some redstone dust on top and on top of that as well. See? Then you're going to place a sticky piston inside with a block right on top and a repeater on top of that on two ticks. Perfect. Alright, so we should have this kind of format. Now I want you to place a sticky piston right there for that redstone dust with a block in front of it. Then you place a block there. And you're going to place a repeater going forward on two ticks. Also place that on two ticks as well. And you're going to place a sticky piston right inside of that block right there with a block on top. And place some redstone dust in front of each repeater. And one right there in front of that block. Now at this point, you're going to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 repeaters. And right there, place one block. Now what we're going to do here is create a timing for the Minecraft time setting. So right over here, you're going to put that on 4 ticks, 4 ticks, 4 ticks, that one, and that one as well. But you're going to leave this one, the first one, on 1 tick. Okay? And that's going to be the setting for the Minecraft time. Okay? Now at this point, you're going to place a repeater going forward on 2 ticks. A block right in front of it. And a block on top at that angle, place some redstone dust underneath, and two right on top. Awesome. Alright. So you should have this kind of layout. Now let's test it out. I'm going to show you how this works once you press the button. So once you activate this, you're going to notice it's going to create a quick setting pulse. It's going to go off at the exact setting for the Minecraft time, because Minecraft time is a little funny and it's a bit faster. So you do have to change that up slightly and you have to really arrange the numbers differently, which I'll show you later on. Perfect. Now we can see that it works perfectly fine. Now I'm going to show you the settings to make this in real time. Okay? So everything pretty much stays the same at this point. Repeater stays there. You're going to put a redstone dust there, a block right there on the side, a comparator going towards that block, leave two spaces with a comparator there, and what we're going to create is a hopper timer. So place two hoppers right there facing each other. Then you're going to place a block, place a block right there, some redstone dust on each side, a sticky piston right there going inwards, and there as well. You're going to delete those two blocks and place torches right inside. A block on top right there. And right behind there, place the redstone dust. Then you're going to place a redstone torch in front of that block. Now, to get the exact timing, you're going to place 75 blocks of any item. Okay, so in this case, we're going to use dirt. And we're going to place 75 blocks inside the hopper. Now, from my understanding, that actually creates exactly 1 minute, which is perfect. Then you're going to put a repeater right there and set it on two ticks. Okay. And that's pretty much it. Now, we're going to start this tutorial back on the Minecraft setting, okay? But if you want the real time, that's all you have to do. So once we're back, at this point, we're going to go right here to the front and place one regular piston right there. Then you're going to place a 4x4 setting of blocks right on top, you see? So you should have this kind of setup right here, just like so. You're going to delete that, place a piston going forward, like so. Place two blocks right there on top, delete that, place a piston going downwards, delete that. And on the side over here, place two blocks, one, two, delete that, and place the piston going inwards. You see? It's pushing forward. And it should look just like this at this point. Now, we're going to delete these blocks. That was just temporary. That was just to give us the exact format to really help us set up the framework. And at this point, you'll place one block there and delete the one in the middle, okay? You're going to place a torch on top of that block to extend the piston, a repeater going towards that block, and a straight line of redstone dust. Now, you're going to place a block on top of that with a half slab on the side. Delete that. Block on top, half slab on the side. Delete that. Then one on top and on the opposite end. Delete that. And place two blocks right there and delete the first one. Then you're going to place a half slab going towards that dropper, towards that piston with a block on top of the piston. Place a torch right there and place some redstone dust going upwards. Then you're going to place some redstone dust right there and three half slabs going forward with a block on top of that piston. And three redstone dust going across. Now right over here, you're going to place a repeater on three ticks, okay? Make sure it's on three ticks. And that's pretty much the bulk of the repeaters as far as actually controlling the pistons itself. Now we're going to use some blue wool to really indicate the coding of this system, okay? Now all you have to do is make sure you delete this block right there. Okay, that has to be empty. Perfect. Now we do have that and we're going to use that for the coding itself. So let's test it out and see if this works. Now we're going to hit that button, and you notice it's going to start revolving perfectly fine. Look at that, that's awesome. Now at this point, place a piston right over here. Well, let's delete this for now. And we're pretty much just going to add 7 more pistons next to each one, making a total of 8 pistons going across, okay? So in total, guys, you should have 8 pistons going right across, just like so. Now to activate each piston, all you have to do is place some blocks right across over here, on top of here as well, and right on the side, just like so. And all you have to do, guys, is just place some redstone dust in a straight line. And that's it, man. And the great thing is, they're all going to work in perfect unison. So you don't have to worry about any kind of lag going on. Now we're going to place our block of coding, which I like to call it, and just cover this up, okay? Then you'll place some blocks right on top. Just like so. And here as well, okay? Now we're just going to leave it halfway. Perfect. Now at this point, you should have this kind of format. Okay, guys? So I want you to leave it halfway because we have a few things we have to do on the inside. Now we're going to delete this right here on the side and we're going to place some glass. Now that's what's going to cause the section next to it to get activated. And I'll show you how that works. And you're going to place some half slabs right across, just like so on both sides. And on top, you're going to place some repeaters, but right here where the glass is at, you're going to switch it up and do it the opposite direction. Then right behind each repeater, you're going to place a lever and you're going to activate it, because those need to stay on at all times. Perfect. Now, once you've done that, you're going to place a half slab starting there and leave a space in between. See? Then in that space, you're going to place a solid block. Then you're going to place a block in front of it with a half slab underneath and delete that. And you want to create that same exact pattern in front of each block. See? Delete those two on each side. And you should have this kind of look. Now let's go right here on the inside, and on top of those half slabs you first place, you're going to place a repeater right on top of it. And on those half slabs as well, you're going to also place a repeater going forward. Perfect. Then right here on those side blocks, I want you to place one piece of redstone dust. Then you're going to place a half slab to extend it forward, and you're also going to place some more dust right on top of it. Now at this point, you could then cover it up. Okay, so place your blocks right here, right across, and here as well. Now that glass that I was talking about on the side right here, certain numbers needs to activate the section right next to it. So this is going to really help us out to determine which numbers need to activate the one next to it, because then we're going to switch that with a solid block, which I'll explain later. Now make sure this section here is always empty. Perfect. Alright, so let's test this out and see how this works. Now the second you hit that button, you're going to notice instantly that all the pistons are going to work real smooth. You see? Look at that. Now once we've done that, we're going to work on the second section, okay? Now the second section will be a little different. So you're going to go about two blocks, and on the third block, place a block right there. See, 1-2 spacing. Place a block right there with a repeater on top of it. You're going to delete that. Then you're going to extend that 7 more times, making a total of 8 pistons going right across. Then you're going to place a block there and there, delete that. You're going to replace a repeater going forward on 2 ticks, delete that. And you want to place a piston, well, a sticky piston on the inside with a block right on top. Now all you have to do is place some redstone dust in a straight line and delete that. And all you have to do is make that, or place a button right there to activate the entire system. Then you can place some redstone dust on top of those blocks. Now it's really that simple, guys. Now like I was saying earlier, you're going to place a half step right there, parallel to that. And you want to place a repeater going forward. Now whatever you do, guys, do not place a block in front of it, okay? What you need to do is place a sticky piston going forward. See? It should have this kind of format. And a redstone block on top of it. Well, just like so. Now you're going to leave 1-2 blocks there, delete the first one. Then you'll place another block going sideways like so, delete those two. Any block right there, okay? So you want to go parallel to the one next to it, that system right next to it. Now you're just going to place some redstone dust just like so and stretch that right across. So you get roughly, well, it went a little too far. Let's delete these two. Right here to that block right there. And you can place a repeater on 2 ticks. And then once again, you're going to place a sticky piston right there with a block right in front. And guys, it is that simple. It's that simple to really activate the system next to it. Great. Now, these two sections, which is section 2 and 3, which we're going to be working on, are going to be slightly bigger than the one next to it. Now, let me show you why. We actually have to add an extra block in the middle. See? So it will be the same exact height, but it will be one block wider. For the simple fact of coding, it actually needs an additional 2 coatings, which I'll pretty much show you and explain more in detail how that works. Okay? Perfect. Then you place a sticky piston right there, and we're pretty much going to create the same exact layout, guys. Have a piston on that corner going downwards, delete that. Place two blocks on the side, delete that, and you want a regular piston going forward, okay? Let's put that right back, delete that, and of course, delete the one in the corner. Now we're going to take these off, because that's just the framework, just to get us the right setting. But like I said, guys, it's only one block wider in the center, okay? Now, once you extend the pistons on both sides, you should have this kind of format, okay? Eight pistons right across, just like so. Now, because section 2 and 3, which we're going to be working on, are the same exact layout, we're just going to repeat the process one more time. So place a regular piston there. Two blocks on the side, right on top of each, pretty much each side, each corner, just like so. And all we're doing is replicating the same exact thing one more time. But just bear in mind, there always needs to be a two block spacing between each section. Now, once you've extended both of them, making each side 8 wide, I want you to place a block right there, a block there, a repeater going forward on two ticks, once again. And you're going to place a sticky piston right there with a block on top, and two pieces of redstone dust on top of that block. Then, of course, we're going to place one straight line of redstone dust, delete that, and that's where you're going to put your button at, okay? So you can manually change the numbers if you want to. Now, just to make everything even, I'm just going to put wooden buttons here as well, just to have that same exact look on all ends. And at this point, you're going to place some redstone dust underneath that block and extend it forward until you get parallel to this point. Now, you're going to place a block there, a torch underneath, delete that, a torch right underneath to activate that, and a repeater going forward. Now, of course, we're going to repeat the same thing to the one next to it. So, place a block there, a torch underneath with a repeater going forward. Add some redstone dust in a straight line leading to that block. Fantastic. Now, you're going to place a block there with a half slab on the side. Delete that. Block there, going one more time backwards. Delete that. Block there, going inwards with a half slab. Delete that. Then two blocks on top and delete the first one. Perfect. Then you can place some redstone dust going upwards with a torch on top with a half slab going forward. And now let's go over here and repeat the same exact thing. So a block on top with a half slab, a block on top with a half slab, delete that. A block on top with a half slab going inwards, delete that. And of course, two more blocks and delete the first one. Fantastic. So you should have this format. Then you're going to place some redstone dust going upwards towards that block with a torch on top of it. Then place a half slab right there with some redstone dust going forward and here as well. And at this point, place a block on top, right on top of that piston. And we're going to extend four half slabs going forward. Just like so, and a block right there. Then you'll repeat that one more time, guys, with a block right on top of that piston. Now, right there, you're going to place a repeater on three ticks, okay? It's very important. And here as well. Then stress some redstone dust across on both ends. Now we got the hard part done on both ends, on both sections. Now at this point, all we have to do is place some blocks right across each piston with some redstone dust on top of it. And that's pretty much it. That's what it really takes to really activate all the pistons in unison. You want to work this in perfect sequence, you know? And here as well, place some redstone dust right on top. And we're going to go to the back part of this. Place some blocks right on top. Hold on. Let me put that piston right back. Then we're going to place some blocks right on top and put some redstone dust right across. And of course, we're going to repeat this on the other side. Place some redstone dust straight across. Great. All right, so it's really coming together, guys. Now over here, this always needs to be activated, so don't worry about that. And once again, we're going to repeat it on both sides. Now this does get very repetitive. Now at this point, pause the video, and you're going to create this nice little section here like we did with the first one, okay? Now once you've done that, you're going to place some half slabs right across. But in this case, you're going to delete that and place the half slab on the left, you see? Right there and there as well, creating this kind of format. Like I said, guys, the two sections in the center, well, these two sections we're working at, are going to be one block wider than the first one. Because there needs to be some extra coating that we have to put for these sections. Then, of course, you're going to place your repeaters and levers, and just make sure you activate all the repeaters. Fantastic. Now, once you've done that, we're once again going to place a half slab there and leave a space in between, just like so. And place a block right in front of it. Then we're going to do that one more time with a block on the inside, just like so. And I want you to place a block there and a half slab underneath. And pretty much do that in front of each block. You see? Awesome. All right. Then you're going to place a block there, and then once, of course, it gets very repetitive, guys. So you pretty much get the gist at this point. Fantastic. Now we're going to extend the half slabs on top forward about one more block. Now right over here on the side, you're going to place some repeaters on every other half slab, you see? Then some redstone dust in between on the solid blocks. So repeater, just like so, some redstone dust in between, and right here on top, we're going to place the repeaters on the inside, and of course, some redstone dust on top of the half slabs. Perfect. Place some there as well. And we should have this kind of layout, guys. Now, of course, we're just going to cover this up, just like so. And once you covered it all up, I want you to go straight to the back over here. Place a half slab right there. And right here as well. It has to be parallel to the repeater right behind it, you see? Then you're going to place a repeater on top of that half slab. And a sticky piston going right in front of that repeater, just like so. See? And a redstone block in front of it. Fantastic. All right. Now, we got to connect this so that it activates the section next to it. So, we're going to place two blocks there, delete the first one. Place a block right there, delete that. Then, you're going to place a block going inwards right there. Now, we're going to place some redstone dust going downwards, straight across. So we get to that point, and we have to place a repeater in front of this block right here, you see? And make sure it's on two ticks. And right behind it, add a piston, a sticky piston with a block on top, because we need to create a quick pulse so it doesn't jam up the system. And guys, it's that simple. Now, on the fourth section, which are going to be the hours of the clock, is going to be slightly different. Now, of course, we're going to leave two blocks of spacing, one, two, three, delete those two. Place a piston right on top. Let me get some pistons. And you're going to delete that block, of course. And what you want to do is create a 4x4 spacing, you see? Now, we're going to repeat the same thing we did in the front, but it's going to be a lot smaller as far as width, all right? So delete that, place a piston going forward, delete that, place two blocks on top just like so, place a piston going downwards, delete that, and of course on the side as well. Now this format is going to be a 4x4 spacing like we did with the first one, you see? So we're pretty much going back to the small one. Now delete that up, because those blocks were just to really help us out as far as positioning the pistons. And you're going to add two more pistons, guys. So it's just going to be three wide, all right? Delete that. Make sure they're regular pistons. Now the fourth section is only going to be three wide, and I'll show you why. Then you're going to place some blocks right there on the side. And once again, we're going to repeat the same exact process, guys. Put a repeater there on two ticks, delete that, put a sticky piston in front with a block on top. Then of course, we're going to add some redstone dust straight across because that's going to activate or lead to the button so we have a manual activation. In case we want to change the numbers or the setting or for whatever reason. You always need a manual override. Then you're going to place a repeater right there also on two ticks. Put a piston there, or a sticky piston there with a block right on top of it. Fantastic. Then we're going to stretch some redstone dust right across. And of course, we're going to place two blocks right there. Delete the first one. Place a block right here. Delete that. And one block going forward. Then we're going to connect the rest of the redstone dust till you get to the top of that block right there. Perfect. Now, guys, I realized that I might have made a small mistake. We actually have to push this back just a little bit, guys. Before we do that, let me just put some dust there. Delete that. Place a torch there. And a repeater going towards that block, okay? It's a block on top with a half slab on the side. Delete that. Block on top, half slab there. Delete that. Block on top, half slab there, and delete that. And of course, you're going to place two blocks right on top. One, two, delete that. And let's get some redstone dust going upwards. One, two, three, and four, and a torch on top of that block. Then we're going to place a block, a half slab right there, with a block right on top with some redstone dust going straight across. Then you're going to place three half slabs with a block going straight across like so. And a repeater right there on three ticks. One, two, three. And some redstone dust right across it. You see? Now, before I fix the front part, let me just add the rest of the redstone dust right here. And two blocks right there. And add some redstone dust right across. And we're going to add some blocks right here. And like I said, guys, previously, we're going to fix this right now. I actually made this a little too small. You got to push it back just one block, all right? You see? So we're going to delete that. Delete that. Place a sticky piston there with a block on top with a block on the side of it. You see? Now, what we're doing is just transferring it one block forward, guys. I apologize about that. Block on top with some redstone dust going towards that. A repeater there on two ticks, repeater there on two ticks, and of course a block right there and right on top of that redstone dust we just placed. And of course we got the same format. With some redstone dust on top, and there you have it, guys. Little mistake is corrected. Fantastic. Alright, so we should have this format. Now, of course, we're going to repeat the same thing, make this little edge piece right here on front. So if you need to pause it, pause it. Then you're going to place some half slabs right across just like so. And on the side, you're going to place two repeaters, one repeater there, and of course place a lever to activate each one. Then for this side, place a half slab there and a block, you know what, right there on the inside. Then a block on top with a half slab underneath, delete that. And extend the half slab right there as well. You want to place some redstone dust on top of that block with a repeater next to it, some redstone dust there, and a repeater on top of that half slab right there. Then of course, once you're done, you're going to cover that up and add some glass right there on the side of it. Perfect. Now at this point, guys, we're going to leave it off at here. And just make sure you watch part 2 to finish up the coating and pretty much the rest of the system. Anyway, guys, I want to thank everybody for watching. Remember to please leave a comment and subscribe. Thank you.